It may be the biggest hack ever into the government's computers. And now it turns out it was even worse than the Obama administration admitted. The hackers now have the personal information of all government employees.
And the hackers were so successful, the break-in to the computers reportedly wasn't even detected for more than a year. Ephraim Graham has the story.
A major federal union says the hackers targeted the central personnel data file of the government's Office of Personnel Management. It contains personal information on federal employees, including sensitive details from background checks. Union President David Cox wrote to the OPM management saying, "The hackers are now in possession of all personnel data for every federal employee, every federal retiree, and up to 1 million former federal employees." The hackers, in essence, raided the government's human resources files. The union believes they took the most potentially damaging information on federal workers. The stolen data includes addresses, birth dates, job and pay history, health insurance, and pension information.
The government is scrambling to try to figure out, you know, what information was actually lost and exfiltrated by this hack. And we're talking about potentially very sensitive employee personally identifying information. And one of the questions is, are there employees of the intelligence community included in this group?
So far, the White House is saying little.
They are working actively to understand exactly the scope of this particular intrusion, but also to determine who is responsible and to make sure that we can take steps that are necessary to hold the individuals who are responsible for this incident.
U.S. officials have hesitated to publicly blame China, which denies involvement. But Senate Democratic Leader Harry Reid says the hack was carried out by the Chinese, although he didn't specify if it was the government or private hackers. Republican Senator Susan Collins, an Intelligence Committee member, also said the hack came from China. The former House Intelligence Chair says the Chinese have been trying to assemble a database of information on Americans for some time. The goals could include using personal details for blackmail or creating bogus emails, which could then become entry points to inject more spyware into government agencies. Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Well, in other news, the Senate is about to take on a major debate over one of the biggest social issues in America. John Jessup has that story from our CBN News Bureau in Washington. John?
That's right, Gordon. The Senate is taking up a ban on abortions after 20 weeks. Supporters say the measure makes sense, arguing that science shows unborn babies at that stage can feel pain. Paul Strand has this story from Capitol Hill.
Senator Lindsey Graham already has 45 co-sponsors as he introduces a ban on abortions of the unborn 20 weeks or older. He says America needs to have a debate on this.
What I want to do is to make the American people think long and hard about wholesale abortions at 20 weeks.
National Right to Life President Carol Tobias admits passage in the Senate is an uphill battle. That's because 60 votes are needed for the debate to go forward, and Democrats are a solid wall of opposition.
The Democratic Party is in lockstep with the abortion movement. They don't want any limits on abortion at any time during pregnancy.
Marjorie Dannenfelser of the pro-life Susan B. Anthony list.
60 votes is a heavy lift, but God is good, and senators have consciences, so it is certainly possible.
If this bill does pass in the Senate, it's certain to face a presidential veto, but supporters say it's still a fight worth having.
Part of the whole strategy here is to build support for a pro-life president. That's the reality. Every single presidential candidate that's running on the GOP side so far has written their own personal statement communicating how much they support this bill and what they're willing to do. My greatest hope is that this will be signed into law February 2017 with a brand new pro-life president.
But as the Senate tussles over the issue, Tobias warns lawmakers and the public to beware of what they hear in the mainstream media.
What they're going to get is inaccurate information. We are being told that babies past 20 weeks can't survive, and they can. We are being told that babies at 20 weeks can't feel pain, and they can.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Capitol Hill.
The ban already passed the House, and more than 60% of Americans support such a ban. State workers in North Carolina who oppose same-sex marriage no longer have to assist gay couples wanting to marry. That's because a new law allows for a religious exemption so those employees can opt out. It would benefit people like John Callum, a former magistrate who gave up his job last fall rather than be forced to perform gay wedding ceremonies.
You know, Genesis 2:24 is pretty clear, you know, about marriage being instituted by God.
Legal challenges are expected. Well, the government is working on ways to identify people by their tattoos. The National Institute for Standards and Technology hosted a challenge for groups to create the most accurate software and algorithms for tattoo identification. A computer scientist tells the Washington Post the main reason the government wants the IDs is to track down criminals. But a legal expert questions if the law has caught up with how image recognition with tattoos could be used, since people are being identified remotely without even knowing it. And Gordon, this raises a host of legal and technological issues.
Well, part of the problem is that it's actually behind the times. If you're doing ID based on tattoos, the latest is IDs based on retinas, and that from remote cameras. So all your eyes have to do is be open, and you walk in front of that camera, and they have the ability coming soon to be able to identify you, and that will be a very specific identification, much better than what's currently being used with face identification, facial recognition. If any familiarity at all with Facebook, you already know about the Facebook tagging and how that's able to follow all pictures of you on social media. So this is a brave new world, and remote identification with all kinds of big data coming along with it, identifying who you are, what are your preferences, what do you like to do, tagging GPS data to that, where have you been. The tracking ability now that technology has is frankly frightening, and from a privacy standpoint, our laws are nowhere near to catching up.